Hello, and this is going to be an installment of my Life Through the Eyes of a Storyteller series. And today, it happens to be Halloween. This is my friend George, my pet gargoyle. Of course, he's stoned right now, but, you know, let's not hold that against him. In any case, let's just jump right into this. My last version of this, I kind of screwed up and was using the wrong mic. I got the right one this time, so the sound quality should actually be correct. I don't need all the echoes. Okay, where were we? Oh, yeah. When I last left off in the prior installment, which is on a different channel. I'll get to that. We were talking about memories and how your mind likes to play tricks on you. Looking back isn't enough. All those fragmented little snippets of memory, they feel real. But are they? Can we ever really tell the difference? I vividly remember laying in a crib as an infant. The mobile hanging above my crib was a much-loved toy. Well, the room was bright. The moment the lights went off, it became an object of torment. It wasn't merely the shadows of beastly animals which you cast into the darkened walls. The mobile itself was ominous, like the fingers of some foul beast reaching out for me. I laid there silently staring at it, trying to move. Outside the room, I could hear footsteps slowly getting closer. My crib was in a room which would later be my older brother's room. I know this from my current knowledge of the positioning of the doors and windows. I had a moment of relief when my mother entered the room and turned on the light. There were boxes and old furniture stacked just beyond the outside of the crib, far enough that I couldn't reach, but close enough to feel like it could come crashing down around me any moment. Moments later, when the light was turned off and the door was closed, only a thin sliver of light was there to chase back the shadows. I listened with dread as my mother walked back down the stairs. A vaguely humanoid shadow passed in front of the hallway light. I screamed until I heard the familiar sound of my mother's footsteps coming up the stairs. The strange shadow vanished. This was repeated several times until my mother decided to finally leave the door completely open, bathing me in the soft light from the hallway. I watched the doorway, waiting to see if the shadow would reappear. I couldn't say how long I laid there staring in silence. I knew it was there. But how could something made of shadow block that much visible light? It moved again in the open doorway, and began to move closer and closer. The instant before it touched me, I had become the shadow, looking down at myself. Sounds like a fantastic tale, and not unbelievable, but certainly. But the memory is very real. This is a sort of game a person's mind can play when you're trying to recall events from long ago. It's one of my earliest memories, as well as one of the most vivid. It feels more real than many of my other early memories. However, I know the memory to be false, and not just because of the fantastic nature of the memory. There's another inconsistency. There are a lot of alternative versions of the same memory in which some events and the scenery are slightly different. It was, in actuality, a recurrent dream which I'd had at a young age. I suffered from night terrors, you see. And this strange, distorted memory is left over from that time period. It's but one of many ways in which my early childhood is a good demonstration of why the phrase, "May you have an interesting life," is an ancient Chinese curse. It's also validation of how the borders between realities blurs, time distorts the memories of one's primordial youth. As I said, seeking out my earliest memories, there will always be the question of exactly where the truth dissolves into fantasy. Sometimes it's better to enjoy the ride. After all, we carry wondrous memories within each and every one of us, many of which are like once brightly painted walls worn by the sun, wind, and rain until we've long forgotten what the true color had once been. You can either spend your time focusing and trying to discern what that color was, or just appreciate it as it is, weathered with time, life, and experience. Happy Halloween, and have a good day. we all carry such wonderful memories within us, many of which are like brightly painted walls worn by the sun, wind, and rain until we've long forgotten what the true color had once been.